Actually, we're at Hearts all our life, rearing them and keeping them going. We train them for the past 15 years. Then we rent to where we were this morning, the hill off Aidan and Emery, and we keep a dozen pint of pointers there and run them, sell them, hopefully keep them moving, buy them. They'll be all well-bred stock we buy as foals and we rear them at home. It's just something we were doing all our life. We keep doing it, hopefully, if we can afford it. Some fellas buy houses, some fellas take drugs. I do that, like, I suppose that's about it. I mean, it was great to be able to bring those lads down there this morning and show them what goes on. They really appreciate it, and it helps the business. People associate you with the name in England, and we'd have a lot of people coming a long time, and they'd associate you with the horses, and they know what the story is in Manila. And we had a lot of winners. We sold a lot of horses. We've horses in a lot of the top yards in England. Hopefully some of them go on and do the big thing. We had grade one horses ourselves, and we had grade one horses with Aidan when he started off. We were probably the first outside owner he had when he started training National Hunt horses. And we have had great success, great luck, and you know, keep them healthy, feed them well, buy well-bred ones, and work them hard like yourself. Feed yourself well, work yourself hard, and hopefully you get some results. You're looking at him for 4 or 5 years, you're dreaming about him, you're feeding him, you're saying, well this fella's bred to do this fella's bred to do that, and then you just start schooling him, and one fella just takes off like a duck to water, and you say, well, away we have one, you know. You hope he, I mean, you don't always translate it on the track to what you think you have, but you'd be hoping they'd keep going ahead, like, you know, and that's when it's all about a dream, like. The thrill is when you're getting them going first, you're jumping and getting them going, get the fella has the appetite for it. Playing for big stakes, like, they're very valuable if they do the thing right, like a lot of money. So that's like when you're going there, there's probably more tension there. The real kick is getting them going, thinking you have it done. That's I mean, not being cocky, but thinking, hoping you have it done. And the look, I mean, it's all about luck then, having good lads riding them and good lads doing them and hoping that you get there. Well, sure, if you thought about it, like, sure, you go mad, you know, but you just can't, like, I mean, okay, you buy them dear, you buy good ones, but I mean, like, it's like, when they're on the pot, they just all have to swim, you know. I mean, great things happen, terrible things happen, but if you dwell on it, you get very nervous, but you just have to close your eyes and pray for a bit of luck and hope someone is looking after you above. This is a load of King's Theatre horses. He's champion sire now, and he's going very well. There's 8 King's Theatre 4-year-olds there now at the minute. Hopefully, there'll be some of them will go. There's a horse, Manila For You. I think he might be the one, but you never know. You think, like, there's ones we thought 2 months ago might be the ones, and this fella's better than. But then, when you go run him, it's different. You know, just keep him healthy and sound, and you know, keep at him. They're well bred stock, and you hope that they translate. It's like we had really good horses down through the years. Like Manila Lad was a real good horse. Manila Men, Hotel Manila. We won a bumper on the stall with Manila Reception. If you get a winner at some of the festivals, like, it's great. Or if you can have a few quid in one at a big price, like, that's plus. But, like, you don't, you know, you just, you know, a simple thing might, you know, you could be there a day and all the kids will be there and have a great day and everyone's happy, and that might mean more to you than win the big one. You know, you never know. I suppose it's bred into me. I mean, like, mother was steeped in it, her father before, and boss man was steeped in it, and he flapped horses during the war, and he was the greyhounds in the finish, and he sold the greyhound in 1962, and he bought Manila for the price of the dog, you know. So I suppose it's kind of it's a drug, you know. So, I mean, I'd want to be running into a serious machine to be buying another Manila out of what I sell a horse for, like, wouldn't I, you know? I'd like to thank the lads for coming down today and hope they enjoyed it, sure, and tell their buddies about it, and if anybody wants to come and come down, they can stay in the hotel, have a good crack, and come off in the morning and see us. We'll show them whatever is there, whatever's going on. We show the tell the story as it is, and you like it or you don't, that's it. But they all enjoy it. They were very appreciative of this morning now, and they, you know, some lads there probably want to buy a horse. More lads never saw a horse before. They look at it in the betting office. They'll be able to go home and tell their buddies in the pub, we saw him or we saw that. Or another fella said, well, I want to buy him. So hopefully they'll all come back and spend a few quid. Only if it's a couple of pints or if it's a couple of £100,000, I don't mind. But if you get something off them all, it'll keep it going. 5 years' time, I don't know. Hopefully we get a couple sold in the springtime. We'll get a couple. I mean, it's a numbers game. If you're lucky, you get a couple away and they pay for one good one carries 4 or 5 bad ones, middle of the road ones. Like, and, I mean, you're looking for the real one to carry the rest of them, because the ones that are right off are right off. And the ones in the middle of the road will get you some of your money back, but they only get some of your money back. But if you get the real one, he'll pay for a lot of them, you know. Hopefully some of the ones we sold to be lucky, and hopefully it's all about luck, keep them healthy, keep them lucky. That's the job.